Hi, my name is Kenneth and I'm the PSLE Science Specialist here at the Pique Learning Center. Across the next few weeks, I'll be releasing a series of videos to help you to consolidate the concepts that are most important with regard to science so that you can better prepare yourself for the PSLE. Okay, so today we'll be discussing on experimental questions. The first question is, what is the relationship between the distance between the lamb and the plant and the number of bubbles produced? To tackle this kind of questions, we must first find out what are the two variables involved, which can be found in the question itself. So the first one would be the distance between the lamb and the plant, and the second would be the number of bubbles produced. So simply taking these two variables and putting it into the answer, I would get the smaller the distance between the lamb and the plant, the larger the number of bubbles produced. I'd like to bring your attention to the comparison terms that I have used in the answer, namely smaller and larger. So taking the two variables and the comparing terms, we can form the answer easily. Right now, I'd like you to take a look at the second question. What is the aim of the experiment? So the template answer to this is to find out if something affects something. So using back the two variables, most students would say to find out if the distance between the lamb and the plant affects the number of bubbles produced. However, this is a higher level thinking skills question where we need to think a little bit further. So, what is the distance between the lamb and the plant representing? So, distance between lamb and plant is representing intensity of light. Number of bubbles produced is representing the rate of photosynthesis. So, put these two back into the question to find out if the intensity of light affects the rate of photosynthesis. So, this would be the accurate answer. Let's look at the third question now. What should be used as a control for the experiment? The tip here is that whatever that is being changed, which in this case is the intensity of the light, should be removed. So basically, we'll be just using the flask with the inverted test tube and the hydrilla plant. The last question that I'll be discussing today is, what is the purpose of the control setup? So every time we mention what is the purpose, it is always to prove something. In this case, it's to prove that the intensity of light in the first place does affect the rate of photosynthesis. So to answer the question, the purpose of the control setup is to prove that the intensity of light affects the rate of photosynthesis. Thank you for watching. I hope that you learned something from this video. If you'd like to sign up for our PSLE final lab preparation program, do contact us at 8621-1533 or click on the link below. Do stay tuned for more of the videos that will be coming up to teach you on concepts and strategies for PSLE. Goodbye.
Hi, my name